Many people consider the Army Reserve as the best part-time job in the world, and for good reason. Today we're going to hear from several different reservists and find out what they think the benefits are to serving their country on a part-time basis.
Right now, someone who joins the Army Reserve in combination with an enlistment bonus, a student loan repayment program, the Montgomery GI Bill, and tuition assistance, we're talking over $50,000 that you can put towards your education to start getting your two-year degree, your four-degree, whatever you want to work on. You know, as far as getting a $20,000 cash bonus, you can go into any business, especially particularly during the holidays. Maybe you might want to work at Walmart and help out during the holiday season, and it's a part-time job. Nobody's going to give you a bonus to go there, but you know, you go get a job for the United States Army Reserve, you're working one week in a month, and you get a $20,000 bonus. You know, I don't think there's any other organization that could top that. Loan repayment program, you know, $20,000. As far as what you get from that entitlement, the thing is with the repayment, it doesn't have to be a loan that you have before you come in. It can be a loan that you get after you're in the Army Reserve, and it's one that Uncle Sam's going to come back and pay for you. You don't have to worry about it anymore. Most students leave college with a four-year degree, you know, owing greater than $40,000, and wouldn't it be nice to have $20,000 taken care of? Maybe you're wanting to have more opportunities as far as being a leader, meet more challenging things, and decide to be a commissioned officer in the United States Army. It's an opportunity for you, so you can still continue to be involved with your unit, and at the same time, go to your university and be involved with the Reserve Officer Training Corps, which is going to give you that opportunity to be a commissioned officer once you complete it. You know, as a reservist, you get opportunities to go and see different parts of the world. You know, it's just not the fact that you're going to go there and spend your time training on your job. The Army's going to give you time off advantages to go and see different things, see how different cultures are. And as far as what I've seen, the thing that just completely blew me away is the things that we have in America that just other people don't get to experience and get to enjoy. But it is an experience to go and see different things. It's being a tourist free. You get to go somewhere for a vacation you didn't even pay for. As an Army Reservist, you might be concerned that the job that you work at, your civilian employer might say, hey, we're requiring you to move. There's a new opportunity for you and you might want to move. You don't have to be concerned that the Army Reserve is going to tie you to your location. You're going to be able to move, find a new unit, and continue your service with the United States Army Reserve. I feel like probably the biggest objection that I talk to when I'm talking to kids about joining the Army that their parents have is they're concerned about them going on a deployment and, you know, just their children as safety. And it's probably one of the hardest things you have to talk to somebody about as far as them understanding that the Army is going to give them all the training that they need that's going to protect them while they are deployed. My biggest advice to the parents that their children want to join the United States Army Reserve is sit down with them. There's a lot of opportunities through GoArmy.com. They can sit down and discuss things together as a family. Even before you would go and talk to somebody about the benefits as far as going to a recruiting station and say, hey, I'd like to know what these benefits are. How are they going to be able to benefit my child? Have all your questions before you even show up, because I'm sure they have the answers for you. And the biggest thing is let go. Understand that they're going to be trained to take care of themselves if they are deployed. When I see a lot of these Army soldiers come home from their reserve training, complete their basic training, their job training, they'll come home. They're from the area, so we see them once again. They'll come into the recruiting station. It actually makes you feel good and feel like you made a change in that person's life for them to come and talk to you. But when they come back, I see a totally different person. I see somebody who's willing to make decisions, you know, a leader. And most importantly, just a well-rounded individual that if I was going to hire somebody, it'd be somebody that I'd be interested in.
Toward my senior year of high school, I found out that there was an Army Reserve band near where I was going to be attending college at the University of Michigan, and I just found out a lot about it, and it seemed like a good opportunity, and it wound up being one of my favorite things I've done.
Primarily joined for school. I didn't have a way to pay for school, and it definitely has helped doing so. When I I first joined, I signed up for a $5,000 signing bonus upon graduating basic training and whatnot, and I got it, and it helped out.
Initially, I actually went active duty, and then I went into the reserve. One, to serve my country, two, to give back to others, not only be selfish in my giving. Teaches me discipline, honesty, respect, give me a sense of responsibility, something that will hold my feet to the fire and hold me accountable.
I've always wanted to join the military, and I wanted to still have a normal life, and I wanted to be able to get my basic training done and out of the way, and then finish high school, and then from there, they pay for my college, help me out with it.
I wanted to help out for, it was in 2004, and I wanted to help out with the whole global war on terrorism and try to help do whatever I could.
Drill weekends, they're always fun. What we do most of the time is, some parts about drill is kind of boring. We have to do classes, but that's just because we aren't here every single day, and they're a monthly class you have to take, and since we only come once a month, we have to take it every time we come. Some weekends we'll go out to the range and qualify with our weapons, and we'll have times where we'll stay out in the field for a weekend. There's good people all around. You're always meeting new people and helping people out. It's a great experience.
Weekends we do driver's training. We learn how to pilot new vehicles. We learn how to perform maintenance and operator's maintenance on these vehicles. And we, of course, do our ordinary soldiering tasks.
Yeah, they definitely are fun. I live 4 hours away, so I drive 4 hours to come here. So, I definitely can say, I like it here. That's the reason I drive 4 hours. And we work well together. We, us as truck drivers, we go around and drive trucks, make sure the equipment on the truck's all running. It is a good time, and it's definitely something different every weekend.
Our drill weekends are actually a little bit different than most other units and MOSs, because we will either come in and perform our job, but we also do everything that everybody else in the Army does too, and I think a lot of people forget that. They just think we're in the band and that's all we do, but we do everything everybody else does.
Biggest benefit to me would be the respect that I get while in uniform from the public.
Friendship. I've met a lot of friends, so I don't think I'll lose any of those, so that's a plus.
You get really good money for college, and you still get to live at home and have a civilian job. It's really good. It's really nice.
I don't think it's really the biggest benefit. Everything is just collectively, all the things that the Army can do for you as a whole is just really amazing.
Was definitely the basic training and leaving my family and testing myself.
The hardest part? Probably the physical activity, I'm not gonna lie. I don't really keep up with the 2 mile run too much, so that's probably the hardest part.
The hardest part was, going away from the family, having to leave, America and go to, overseas to the war. But I don't mind it was a good experience to have.
My deployment to Iraq. I had a good experience there, but the whole separation from the family gets a little rough, but.
Oh, the hardest time for me, being in the reserves, is a little bit of time away from home. I have young family and stuff like that, so I have to take care of them, but I also have to take care of my soldiers too.
The greatest reward for me would probably be just the experience that I've had. You get to travel, you get to go places, meet new people every day, so that's probably the biggest award.
My greatest reward here would be meeting new people, because we're always meeting someone new. You have new people coming in and people going all the time.
The greatest reward is knowing that there's no greater calling than what I'm doing here.
Throwing candy to kids overseas and having them smile, that was pretty fun. They enjoyed that, yeah. It made it seem like we were doing something worthwhile, see the kids happy and whatnot.
Taking care of this country, taking care of anything that needs to be done, and training these soldiers.
That's our show for today. Don't forget that as Americans, we enjoy our freedoms because of those that serve in the military. So the next time you see one of our young soldiers out in public, be sure to stop, shake their hand, and say thanks. For now, I'm Army Sergeant Michael Kyle, and I'll see you next time on In the Know.